At the end, I have asked you, what is the three-lettered word in English which does not contain any vowel? It's only consonants. So the answer, to get that answer, I'll give you one hint. To get that answer, you should try. Try, T-R-Y, no vowels in that. Cry, fly, sky, why, all these are the words. If at all, two-letter word, can you think and answer me, what is the two-letter word? It is by, my, these are the two letter words, right? Come back here. We were discussing about cash from operating activity. I told you there are three activities in cash flow: operating, investing and financing. Under operating, there are two methods, direct method and indirect method. Direct method is collection from customers and payments, whereas under indirect method, you take the reported profit of PBT. You consider depreciation, non-cash item, non-operating item and working capital items. This is what the rough idea I told. Let us look at in detail about the format. So, let us look at the cash from operating activity direct method. So, first thing is, you need to start with collection from customers, less payments, payments to suppliers, employees, nothing but salaries here. Third one is other expenses. Any production, admin, selling expenses you take related to directly or indirectly related to goods and services, all three together you deduct. Then if you, from this collections from customers, this can be two component again. It can be cash sales and collection from debtors. Cash and credit sales will come under your trading account. Under trading account, credit sales, there will be total sales. So, there will be cash sales, immediate collection you can write. But credit sales, from that you have to consider the collection from customers. So, cash sales and collection from customers, what is the yearly collection you made during the year? Then it is about payments to suppliers, employees, other expenses. Deduct it, you will get cash generated from operation. Simple format. Less taxes paid plus or minus extraordinary items. So, extraordinary item means they are not recurring nature. They are unusual items, they are not ordinary items in the business. Few example what you generally in a books course is, let us consider there is an earthquake happened, you lost some amount, or there is a compensation due to your, you know, earthquake loss due to insurance coverage. If it is so, this has to be covered under extraordinary item. There is a case against the company and company has to pay ₹20,000 as per the company, as per the court's verdict. If it is so, that is an extraordinary item. Such items to be taken here, you adjust it. If it is an income, you add. If it is an expense or payment, you deduct. You get cash from operating activity. So, collections and less payments, less taxes paid, plus or minus extraordinary items. So, it means the format is simple. Directly, we have to work out under operating activity, inflows and outflows. Let us look at how your indirect method works. As I said in earlier, there are three items to be taken under indirect method. One is non-cash item, non-operating items, working capital items. What is the base of starting? Under trading and P&L account, you arrive at profit before taxes and extraordinary items. The base is PBT and E, profit before taxes and extraordinary item. First in that, okay, let us make it this way. If I take in a statement form, revenue less various cost, you might have taken depreciation, you might have taken interest on debenture, some example, you might have taken profit or loss on sale of machine, you arrive at PBT, less taxes paid, you will arrive at PAT, reserve and dividend, general reserve and dividend, finally you arrive at profit transfer to balance sheet. Small sketch, I have drawn it. So, we start with profit before taxes and extraordinary item. When you arrive this answer from sales to here, you are going to consider these two items. What are those two items? Non-cash items. They are not cash items, but deducted in accounting. You know, in accounting, it is not cash accounting, it is accrual accounting. Even not paid also, you adjust it. Therefore, any such non-cash item, you have to cancel. Example, depreciation is a non-cash item, you have to cancel. Salary outstanding, you are not paid, you cancel that. Cancel means what? From here deducted. Cancel means it's already minus. You have to add back. Then plus or minus non-operating items. I told there are three activity. Other than the operating activity, any other items are there. That is investing item or financing activity items are there. But from here, when they arrived here, they have adjusted already. You have to add back. In this interest on debenture. Debenture is which activity? Financing activity. Whether we take under P&L account? Absolutely yes, we take it. For P&L purpose, we take it. For cash flow purpose, for operating activity, though it is an expense, even if it is paid, you have to cancel because it is not related to goods. It is not related to your operating activity. It is not related to goods and service. It is some other activity, not operating activity. That is called non-operating item. Similarly, profit or loss on sale of machine we deduct. But it is not related to goods. It is some other activity, investing activity. So, these items to be cancelled. So, this is depreciation comes under non-cash. Plus or minus non-operating interest on debenture or profit or loss on sale of machine or building etc. You cancel it. If it is loss deducted, so add back. If it is profit added already, now deduct back. So, it means from this to this, cancel not related non-cash or it is non-operating. If you cancel items, you will get from profit, you arrive at operating profit before working capital. This is total profit, you arrive at what profit? Operating profit. It means this profit is related to goods and service. There is no non-cash item, there is no other activity or non-operating item. It means from this, if you adjust, you will get purely operating activity item profit. From then, you adjust increase in current asset. These four items you have to adjust. This is before working capital changes. These are the four working capital items. As I said, we need to consider working capital adjustments. There are four components. Current asset, current liability, it can be increase and decrease. Four items are there, you have to consider. What is the impact if it is increase in current asset? Please note, any current asset increases, there will be a corresponding decrease in cash. Example, stock 50,000 to 80,000, what we can predict, what we can assume, 30,000 worth of raw material you purchased, it implies cash gone out. So, increase in current asset, decrease in cash. Suppose you could not understand this logic, you can do like this, that instead of increase in current asset, straight away take something like increase in building, increase in machinery, increase in investment, this is all, it results into purchase. If it is a purchase, what is the impact on cash? Cash goes out, so deduct. Decrease in current asset decreased, stock decreased, you consider stock as sold out. What is the impact on cash? You received, plus, the symbols are important, plus or minus. Increase in current liability, assume there is a overdraft, there is a small overdraft, that overdraft is increased, it means you borrowed more, cash comes in, plus. Not understood, go with any other liability. There is a debenture or there is a loan. Increase means you raised the loan, there is a positive money you got. Decrease in current liability. Your creditors decrease means you paid. Outstanding expense decrease means you paid. Preferential capital reduced means you redeemed. It has gone down. Same impact here, that means cash gone out. It means among the four, first and last where there is an outflow, the middle two, B and C are, there is an inflow. Adjust these four items, it can be positive or negative, you will get cash generated from operations. Please note, moment you get cash generated from operations, both has same working afterwards, that is less taxes paid, plus or minus extraordinary item just I discussed, you get cash from operating activity. So, it means students, there are two methods under operating activity. I summarize once again in very nutshell, please observe properly. Direct method, as the name says, collection from goods or service, relevant payments you deduct. Collections, payment to suppliers, employees means salaries, then other expenses, other production, admin, selling, all related to goods and service, direct or indirect expenses, that is to be deducted. You will get the answer. Taxes paid, adjust it, plus or minus extraordinary items. Now, let us look at the indirect method. Under indirect method, you start with profit before taxes and extraordinary items, PBT. From sales to PBT, you might have taken irrelevant item, not related items. P&L it is correct. For operating activity, we have to cancel. Three items I have taken. Two items here. Non-cash items like depreciation. Plus or minus non-operating means not related to goods. It is related to something else. It is related to investing or financing. Interest on debenture is a financing activity, or interest on investment, if it is there, it is an income, but it is an investment activity. Profit or loss on sale of machine building, that is also not related to goods. It is sale of machine. So these items you have to adjust here, non-operating items. Adjust these two. This amount you have to adjust here. Take it. You will get operating profit before working capital changes. As I said, working capital adjustment you have to do, that has an impact on cash. So there is increase in current asset or decrease in current liability, the cash outflow. Decrease in current asset, increase in current liability, cash inflow. Adjust it. Moment you do these three items, non-cash, non-operating, working capital items, you arrive at cash generated from operation. Please note these both will get the same answer. That means you are direct method and indirect method are two different methods. The point of intersection where they join both methods, it will go in two different routes, but finally it joins at cash generated from operation. You can make out here both same, from then onwards taxes and extraordinary items. So students, when we say keep 2-3 points in mind. First point, when I say current asset or current liability, you have to take all the current assets and current liability, but except cash and cash equivalents. We should not take cash and cash equivalent. That is a reconciliation. When you say operating, investing, financing, finally we have to reconcile that. To reconcile, we should not take cash and cash equivalents. So, question is here, we take current assets, current liability, but when we say current assets, current liability, we should not take cash and cash equivalents. Why we should not take? See, finally we have to reconcile cash and cash equivalents. There are three activities: operating, investing, financing. Let us consider operating, investing and financing. When you work out all three, plus minus all you adjusted, final last answer is plus 10,000. It means cash and cash equivalent increased during the year is 10,000. If there is opening 40,000 balance, year ending there has to be 50,000. 40 plus 10, 50, or difference of 40 and 50 is 10,000. That is a reconciliation. Therefore, that particular asset we should not take. Cash and cash equivalent should not be taken here. Point number one. Students, please note, with the next question, let us go little logical in that. Why we start with PBT? We can start with PAT. We can start with profit transfer to balance sheet. Why that always taken profit before taxes? I have some logics to explain it. Profit before tax, after that, whichever problem you take, here what you take in P&L account is a tax provision. Tax provision made during the year. For accounting purpose, you consider some tax provision. That's not the actual payment. Therefore, actual payment is different and what you provided is different. This is not the paid. Therefore, if I start with the profit after tax, in every problem I have to add back this. Therefore, take this and add back, better directly start with PBT. You may ask this question, why we have to take profit before tax always? Why can't we start with this? See, what are the items adjusted to arrive here? PBT till here, three items: tax, reserve and dividend. Tax I have already said, every problem you cancel. Reserve is not the amount paid to anyone. Therefore, there is no outflow of money. So, you have to cancel back. What about dividend? Even if it is paid, it is not related to operating activity. Dividend is paid on shares. Share is which activity? Financing activity. It means if I start with this, in every problem, I have to cancel dividend, I have to cancel reserve, I have to cancel tax provision. Example, if I say 50, 10, 5, 10, let me say, take some number, 50 minus 10, 40. These two, if I deduct, I will arrive at 25. See, 50, I arrive at 25. Please note, if I start with this, no payment of this. If it is paid also, it is some other activity, I have to add back. 25 plus 10, 35. Reserve not paid, add back. 35 plus 5, 40. Tax provision amount paid is different. Therefore, I have to cancel this. 40 plus 10, 50. It means starting point is profit before tax. Anything below that, in every problem you cancel, that's the way you start with PBT. Suppose in question, if they give PAT, what you should do? Do one step back, PAT, add tax provision, you get PBT. So, you understood why we take PBT and you understood what are the current assets and current liability, creditors, salary outstanding, anything, you know, payables, receivables, debtors and, you know, stock, all those you take. But don't take cash and cash equivalents. I have already explained what is cash and cash equivalents. It includes three: cash in hand, cash at bank and your short term investments. I told you what is short term investment, 3 months, 90 days is the period. I think this is what you have to note in this particular example. Let us summarize before going to the problems, what and all we learned now. Students, please note the format very clearly and, you know, you take this format properly so that if you can practice 2-3 times, definitely one small question will come here and you can score good marks. So, starting point and a direct method. I am telling, entire exercise we are discussing is only operating activity. Investing and financing is direct, I have not told, we will discuss in next. Collection from customers, direct method. Payment to suppliers, employees, other expenses. Cash generated from operations, less taxes paid, plus or minus extraordinary items. So, from here till here once you arrive, taxes and extraordinary items are common here also. What are the items you have to adjust? Under indirect method, you need to take some profit. What is the profit? Profit before taxes and extraordinary item. PBT, okay. What is that PBT and E? Profit before taxes and extraordinary items. In this, any extraordinary items are already deducted or added. Cancel back. Why it is to be cancelled back? As per your accounting standard, they say, in P&L or in cash flow, that extraordinary items should be disclosed separately. As a matter of disclosure, separate you have to show it. That's all. There is no other reason on that. PBT and E. So, when you array PBT from sales, two items you have to cancel, non-cash and non-operating. As the name only says, it is not cash. So, cancel, add back, deducted, add back. Non-operating, it is not operating item, so you have to cancel back. It means to say, from here to here, which is not relevant, I have cancelled. Then I have to consider operating, that answer from profit, it will arrive at operating profit before working capital changes. Adjustment for working capital changes in four form: increase in current asset, decrease in current asset, increase in current liability, decrease in current liability. Increase in current asset, please note, current asset increases, cash decreases and vice versa. Whereas current liability increases, cash also increases. If current liability decreases, cash decreases. These four you have to consider when you take current assets, don't take cash and cash equivalents. Deduct this operating profit and adjust plus or minus these working capital items. You arrive at cash generated from operations. Moment you have cash generated from operations, just like here, taxes, extraordinary items, cash from operating activity. Students, now we learned how do you do the cash from operating activity, direct method and indirect method. Now we will move on to a problem of working direct or indirect method of cash from operating activity.